Hello, future art students. My name is Peter Beck. I'm an art instructor at Marquette University High School, and this short video is kind of an introduction to the curriculum offerings that we have in our art department and to kind of get a sense for what's going on in each one of the art classes. While I may not teach every single art class, I helped write all the courses and I'm very involved in the way that the students move through the department. So what it's really going to be helpful for you is to have access to this little graphic, and I'll put a link to it in the description below. And the little graphic is going to help you understand sort of how you might move through the department. It's really critical to understand that we have sort of three levels of courses in the art department. We have our foundations courses, 2D design, 3D design, and drawing. Then we have our studio focus, or our studio specialty classes. We call them our level two courses, advanced drawing, photography, ceramics, and painting. And then finally, we have our level three course, or our portfolio development course. That's AP Studio Art. It's an AP level class and an advanced portfolio development course, where we spend an entire year developing a portfolio. Now, let's jump all the way back to the beginning. The foundations classes, you can read the little description in their curriculum guide, but it's always really helpful. I'm a visual person. I know that guys signing up for our classes are also visual people too. It's really helpful, I think, to understand what's going on in the class. What kind of projects are you going to get involved in, and sort of where does the instruction go? Now, as a kind of basic understanding in our foundations classes, you should know this, that you can take any one of those three classes and sort of advance in the curriculum. And so you can imagine that each one of those three classes have a lot of things in common. Like, for example, in each one of those classes, you get a sketchbook, you get an art supply kit, and even some of the instruction is sort of similar. Like, for example, in all three classes, 2D, 3D, and drawing, you learn how to draw. Obviously, drawing class is a really dedicated, full-blown semester of drawing, and so it's a bit more in-depth. But even in 2D design, which tends to be more digital, and 3D design, which tends to be more about fabrication, you're still learning to draw. Three different approaches to drawing and how drawing is used, but we're all learning to draw. We're all learning about color theory. We're all learning about basic composition. And we're all learning simple fabrication methods. Now, where some of the classes in the foundations level start to kind of divide, and that may kind of attract you to one versus the other, will be that our only course that has a deliberate digital component to it is 2D design. 2D design makes use of the Adobe Creative Software. Adobe Illustrator is a program that we use heavily in the course in order to sort of bridge the gap between what's going on in your sketchbook and what's sort of possible in the computer. Now, I actually like to think about this as a translation process, so we're going back and forth between the sketchbook and the computer quite often, but it's just good to know that if you really kind of are excited about digital work, 2D design class is probably where you want to be. Now, 3D design class is going to be a little bit more about fabrication and assembly, everything from sort of intricate cut folds of planes, building up solids, and doing simple woodworking with sort of like framing, skin frame projects, and even some sort of bending and ribbon stringer projects. Now, these are not exhaustive. They kind of describe to you the sort of feel for what's going on in the courses, but if you really like to build things with your hands, you're interested in sort of folding, gluing, cutting, shaping, sculpting, molding, that's going to be very much like what's going on in our 3D design class. And depending on skills and aptitude, we may bend it digital one semester, we may bend it really physical and large one semester, or we may bend it towards a particular field depending on where the class is at. But for the most part, we're going to be working with our hands a lot in that course. Now, drawing is going to be a more intensely focused course on developing what we all consider here in the art department to be probably one of our most essential skills to develop as young artists. That is the ability to draw. But not all drawing is created equal, right? In 2D and 3D design, we sort of learn a drawing for designers approach. In the drawing course, we're going to be doing a lot more observational drawing, or drawing from life. And so there's quite a bit more time involved. You spend a lot of time doing drawings in class and working through a variety of projects to develop not only your ability to get things onto the page, but to patiently see. Now, when it comes to finishing that foundations course, you open up the possibility of some of our studio specialties. One of our studio specialty courses, advanced drawing, has a specific prerequisite. Advanced drawing requires that you take drawing your first semester. So if you took 2D design because you really loved the kind of illustrator component, you wanted to do that digital work, but then you still kind of aspire to do a lot of drawing later on, doing your own comic book, for example, maybe your own graphic novel, you're going to want to get into the drawing class. There's no problem with kind of moving sideways in those foundations classes. That's great. All of them are sort of taught at roughly kind of a freshman sophomore level, and so you can kind of move around there to your early years, in your early years as a student at Marquette High. But once you step up to those level two courses, you're stepping up into the sort of sophomore junior level course loads. Basically, it means a little bit more involved work and a little bit more homework involved. Advanced drawing is going to really dig deep into that drawing curriculum, and you could imagine, you know, what you can do in a semester stretches out in the world of drawing, specifically with time involved. Now, we also have a couple of other studio focuses like photography, ceramics, and painting. Painting you could think of as sort of another step in the kind of trajectory of drawing, advanced drawing, and painting. These are somewhat more traditional kind of pathways to move through in the art studios. Ceramics you can think of as a not only a study of traditional pottery forms, functional things like mugs and pots, but also a basic sculpture course where we'll be working with clay as a material, and then we have some kind of sideways movements with other materials like polymer clays, basic stone carving, etc. So think of ceramics as kind of continuing along the trajectory of 3D design, where we're going to be doing things with our hands quite a bit. Photography is a class that kind of continues in the digital trajectory, where if you really liked learning Adobe Illustrator and then you wanted to learn Adobe Photoshop, photography class is where you're going to kind of pick up those skills. In photography class, we sort of look at photography not just from the perspective of our digital devices, right, our smartphones, our DSLRs, but also from the sort of historical technological object, where we're building our own cameras, we're shooting a roll of film, developing it ourselves, we're going to be making prints using simple chemistry, and then also doing all the digital Lightroom work and kind of learning some of the digital tips and tricks. Now, all of that, I would say, is like technical side. We also have sort of the expressive side, everything from taking how to approach people to take good portraits, and how to document an event and tell the truth with your camera. So at that second level, all of the coursework that you're doing addresses not just a technical quality of your work, but also is starting to sort of imagine what sort of poetic use you might put that camera to, or what sort of poetic use you might put that paintbrush to. If you successfully complete a level two course, it opens up then our final sort of junior-senior level course, our advanced portfolio course. Now this, simplistically, you could think would be an excellent course to prepare you for advancing in the arts. It's going to build a portfolio that you could use to apply to art school. It's going to build a portfolio that you could use to apply to internships. But the portfolio experience is not merely for the kind of future artist. The portfolio experience is a capstone project which we spend an entire year developing. Where there is a small sort of written thesis component and a body of artwork that completes it. Developing a portfolio is a really amazing process that's kind of has up a roller coaster of emotional ups and downs. You learn a lot about yourself. You develop your skills. You're no longer doing the teacher's projects, but the teacher works alongside you on your own work. And so it's generally a smaller course between, you know, 5 to 15 students. And the teacher works very closely with each student. Each student is sort of working within a group of creative peers. I'm really excited that you guys are considering signing up for an art course. I'm sure that you probably have a lot more questions and you would like to know more about what's going on in the courses. Please reach out to me in the building, swing by the art studios, have a chat. I'll go ahead and send an email using the email that's listed on the MUHS website. I look forward to seeing you guys in the studios.